Hi friends, welcome back all. And in this video, we're gonna see about MBL Infrastructure Limited. So recently, many of my friends asked, and I do some research work in this company. So what I basically done is, I have taken the events that has happened in this company from 2018 to 2021. So which means I will be covering 18, 19, 20, and 21. So 4 years we have to cover in this video. This video may go up to, go to 5 or 7 or 8 minutes. I think this video is going to be very important. So in a simple language, I'm going to explain what are the events that has happened. So if you take this price graph, 2015 or 2016, the share price was around 300 or 400 or 500 rupees. Then that from 500 or 400, the share gone up to 2 rupees on this March fall that we had during the previous year. Now let us come to a basic point. In a simple stance, what is MBL Infra? It is similar to a knife. If you take this knife using the grip, okay, the grip part of this knife, then you are safe. If you are going to take from this point, the sharp edge point, then you are going to hurt your fingers or hurt your hand, whatever may be cause. Because the events that I am going to cover is going to be very important. So being basically in EPC building, highway infrastructures and being in building blocks, etc. These are the various activities of this company. So what has basically happened during the period of 2018 is that the company was having a 1,500 crores of debt and I think 900 crores of trade receivables. So what is the basic plan of this company was getting the funds from trade receivable or collecting the money that is due to them and paying those amounts which are due to them, okay, by them to them. And this is what this company basic plan was. So the trade receivables amount was not collected properly. There was no proper collecting management. So what basically happened? The expectation of the company failed, and due to that, the interest cost has increased. The company could not pay its debt. So this leads to the first stance called the resolution plan of this company, which was implemented on 19th of February 2018. So we are going to start from 2018. So what has basically happened in 2018 is that the resolution plan was approved, okay. So the company was brought under this NCLT route, under this insolvency and bankruptcy code. So luckily, instead of liquidating the company submitted a formal thing, so by which the resolution plan has been approved. Under this resolution plan, the promoter would increase their holding from 21% to 80.88%. See the heart message of this company while seeing on 18. We have learned from mistakes with better professional management. We shall take the company forward as per the vision and discipline. We have huge opportunities available. So what they are saying is that we have learned from mistakes. We will work good. Okay. And if you go above that, right? And I said that the promoter holding is going to get increased from 20% to 80%. As you can see here, the promoter contributed 606 crore 33 lakh shares. Each share having a price of around 10 rupees. So which means 63 crore and 33 lakhs has been infused with this company into this so-called company. And that is a really very good point that we are having here. This is the first step. This is on 10th July 2018. So moving from here, and this was during this so-called AGM, the company said that there are huge receivables which has caused liquidity. I said, right, whether I'm what I'm saying is wrong or not, as you can see here. There are huge receivables in the company which had discouraged mismatch. The company has taken necessary steps for realization on first receivables. So they are working on collecting this and they are now entering 4 to 5 large ticket size for this. This is as on September 30, 2020. Now moving on to the next factor, and this is one of the clean explanation after this NCLT process, that these are the activities that the company is going to do, like implementation of this debt recast plan, infusion of funds, etc, etc. And moving from this, right, this was this resolution plan. So resolution plan under IBC was this, actually under CARP process or under IBC process, the Insolvency Bankruptcy Code, the creditors would be classified into two. Financial creditors basically mean banks, and operational creditors those who helped during this operation of the company. Okay. So payment of CARP and work as priority, operational and other creditors would be paid in 3 years. So which means basically from 2018 to 2021, all this operational creditors money would be paid off. And also that all the remaining loans has been spread over a period of around 9.575 years. And that is a very good point. Okay. And from this, the equity infusion in terms of the resolution plan, the promoters and promoter group will be I mean, they would be insisting on 128 crores over a period of 3 years. The promoter have already include 63.3 crores. So, another infusion of around 60 crores or 55 crores or whatever the amount may be, the promoter holding would get increased from 68% to 80% as we saw here. Now, hearing all these news would be happy. Okay, the company is saving, company is saving. And another more important point to you. This is as on 2018, the promoter holding has increased to so-called this percentage. Let me show you another important paragraph that I want to show to you, and I want to make sure that you are going to see these main things, okay? And recently the company has got some so-called relief about around 550 crores of relief. I think that is going to be very, very important for this. But above all these factors, what are the greater events that destroy the company's level is that how did this company is going to perform right now? So recently in the annual report by this company, right, during this insolvency process, all the lenders was approved and this process has been completed successfully. But a party who is holding 4% voting power in this company has reinstated this NCLAT order and filed that case in the Supreme Court, and that order is still pending. If the Supreme Court is going to cancel this resolution process, unluckily it's Supreme Court going to cancel, this company may go under liquidation. So now I said, right, the basic thing that this company is a knife, so it depends upon which part of you hold. As you can see here, this is what I'm stating to you. Okay, the company has received legal opinion, the resolution plan may is legally approved and is binding all stakeholders. There's no merit in the appeal of the file. If the in the unlikely event of the ultimate rejection of the resolution plan, the company may go under liquidation. So this is as on the 1920 annual report for further confusion, as you can see here. So this is the 1920 annual report of this company that I'm showing you right now. So these are the various the risk as well as the good thing of this company, because all these events is going to play a main role in this company's shareholders point of view. Now if you ask me whether I can enter this company right now, because the so-called, I mean, they have this good business, and recently they have won around 553 crores of arbitrational award because this fund, the dues they are collecting was from trade receivable. That is a very good one, because it could increase the cash flow of this company and the company market capital could improve. So within 3 years, the promoter want to infuse the remaining 12 or 13% of percentage of shareholding. So which is going to end on, I think, around April or May or July month of 2021. And this operation creditor dues will be fully paid. And the third thing is this, whether the Supreme Court case is going to get completed or not. If that is going to be bad, then forget that there would never be a company called Gambit Fraser Limited. But I hope, or I don't believe, that this things could happen. But we can't predict anything, right? Because it is up to the Honorable Supreme Court to decide what they are going to do based upon the case which is being going on. So now if you ask me whether can I invest in this company right now. So if you really feel that, I mean, all the things are good apart from this filing of Supreme Court case, if you want to invest, the better idea is that don't invest your capital amount. Suppose you have earned around 1000 rupees of profit in some other share. Let us assume that if you have earned around 1000 rupees of profit in Suzlon Energy. Let us take an assumption, okay? Take that 1000 rupees profit alone and then invest in this company. Only invest your profit, not your capital amount, because anything goes wrong, only your profit will be going, not your capital. But the future prospect is good. Let us assume the Supreme Court case is going to get cancelled due to its unmerit or no merit things. The company could get multifold returns and already done this from 2 rupees to 22 rupees. But it all depends upon how this company is going to do these things. Thank you, friends, and bye. And I'll see the video very soon.